The Admiral Broadway Revue, brought to you by your Admiral dealer, the man to see for Admiral dual-temp refrigerators, Admiral electric ranges, Admiral radios, phonographs, and magic mirror television. It's the Admiral Broadway Revue, world through. Broadway Revue, this week with a happy blend of song, dance, and comedy, takes you on a world cruise.
In the Hudson, there's the big Queen Mary beside the Staten Island Ferry, and all the ships have got their flags unfurled. Tycoons and famous dress designers are boarding great big ocean liners, starting on a cruise around the world. On luxury ships for us there's an embargo. When we travel, we'll go with the cargo.
We'll hop on freighter to Zanzibar. They say that Zanzibar is very far. Oh, Zanzibar is far across the sea. Across the sea is nice to be.
We'll catch a schooner to Trinidad. To go to Trinidad is quite the fad. It's quite the fad to pack your brush and roll and trot along the globe.
We'll visit Greece with just one valise. If our boat should crease, it's a shame. We may not go with a lot of dough. We'll get there just the same.
Hop a freighter, we'll board a boat.
We'll go on any boat that stays afloat.
And then we'll float to some remote little state or any place on the equator that's far.
We'll hop a freighter to Zanzibar.
We'll travel down the Nile upon a crocodile. We'll get a boat, we've got a visa.
Drink Italian wine, and when we're feeling fine, we'll straighten out the Tower of Pisa.
We'll go to Paris, we'll go to Prague,
we'll go to London and lift the bar.
We'll go to India, and when we're in Bombay,
we'll spin the whirling dervishes the other way.
We'll catch a steamer to Singapore.
They say that Singapore is on a shore.
It's on a shore that we'll explore in China, in a ritual that is one of
the stars.
Hop a freighter to Zanzibar.
cluster is hallowed ground. This is probably the most romantic spot that you will find anywhere from Cairo to Johannesburg. In this tent that you're about to enter, you will find the son of the son of the son of the sheik.
The real son of the son of the son of the sheik?
The direct descendant and the heir to all the movie royalties.
Oh, I can't believe it. That I, Elizabeth Buster of Paterson, New Jersey, am standing in the middle of the Egyptian desert, on the very desert where Rudolph Valentino stood. There's such an aura about the place. I can feel it. I can hear it. I can smell it.
That's just the camels. You'll get used to that after a while.
Where is he now? Where is the young sheik?
Who knows? Off on some mysterious errand, no doubt. But he'll probably be back very soon.
Well, do you think if I waited around, I could catch a glimpse of him?
Well, you might try. Would you like to wait alone?
Oh, you're so understanding. Oh, the Sheik of Araby. So dark, passionate, as mysterious as the Egyptian night. As tender as the desert moon, riding swiftly over the dark sands into a secret romantic rendezvous. New Jersey was never like this. Oh, incense! How perfect! How Eastern!
Ah! Woman!
I want you. Come. Come away from this air wick and into my arms.
I didn't expect this.
Ah, these many moons I have searched for you. Yes, you. I have searched for you night and day. Day and night. Up the Nile. Down the Nile. You. I need you. Not the pillow. You. You! It is fate! Fate! Now you can't escape me. No, because it was written in the stars long ago that you shall be mine. Mine, you hear? It is fate! I have waited for this moment for a long time. You shall be no one else's. Mine alone, you hear? Now that I have you, we must not wait a second.
It's not like this in the movie!
This is real. Nothing else matters. You are mine, you hear? Mine alone. I no one else shall have you. I shall kill us both. You're everything to me. Everything, you hear? No one else shall have you. I must have you, you hear? I want you. You must be mine alone. End these days of torture. Don't say it. Don't refuse me. Don't say you refuse me. Or else I'll go mad. Mad, you hear? Mad. I must have you. Where are you? There you are. I must have you here. I need you. I want you. I must have you. You hear? I need you. I. Will you join my pyramid club?
Ladies and gentlemen, Phyllis Clare.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mary McCarthy.
Deep in the jungles of Africa, I've studied jungle lore. I've explored jungles in Africa that Frank Buck refused to explore. Out where the lions and tigers roam, I've built a little home. Jungle drums, beating day and night. Jungle drums, lions left and right. Cannibals waiting near my hut. Cannibals eating you know what. Africa's a scary place, but I'm a fearless fighter. I've been through darkest Africa with just a Ronson lighter. Tonight. I wonder what can be keeping Reggie. I hope he's not having any trouble with those Ubangis. I told him not to take any of their lips. Listen, listen to those drums. Ah, the natives are restless tonight. Bumble. What are the drums saying tonight? Listen.
The drums are saying, bump diddy bump diddy bump diddy bump.
I was afraid of that. Oh, this heat is driving me mad. It's driving me crazy. I'm not very hungry. Just give me a snack. Give me a glass of milk and put this between two pieces of bread. Just a moment for you. The drums, they never see.
Ladies and gentlemen, Earl Wrightson.
I won't kiss your hand, madame. Crazy for you, though I am. I'll never woo you on bended knee. No, madame, not me. We don't need that flowery fuss. No, sir, madame, not for us. My romance doesn't have to have a moon in the sky. My romance doesn't need a blue lagoon standing by. No month of May, no twinkling star, no hideaway, no soft guitar. My romance doesn't need a castle rising in Spain, nor a dance a constantly surprising refrain. Wide awake, I can make my most fantastic dreams come true. My romance doesn't need a thing but you. It's romantic merely to be young on such a night as this. Isn't it romantic? Every note that's sung is like a lover's kiss. Sweet symbols in the moonlight, do you mean that I will fall in love perchance? Castle rising in Spain, nor a dance to a constantly surprising refrain. Wide awake, I can make my most fantastic dreams come true. My romance doesn't need a but you.
Woo! and it lost its ecstasy. My heart fell on and fell.
Documentary of life in America today on land, on sea, and in the air. A panorama of the faces and voices of the most unimportant people of our time. In the little town in Iowa, Mrs. Minnie Minipus was voted the best dressed woman of the year.
Now, we thought it would be interesting to hear what Mrs. Minipuss has to say about the ever-changing trends in styles and glamour. And so, here she is, Mrs. Marjorie Minipuss, the best-dressed woman of the year. Mrs. Minipuss, I want you to know that it's a distinct pleasure and a privilege to have you with us today. As you know, there are many ladies in our audience, and I'm sure they're waiting to hear the secret of your sartorial perfection.
Well, there are lots of things I could say. Being an authority on style and naturally having investigated what consists of a well-dressed woman for a number of years, there are any number of things I could say. But as every well-dressed woman has known and always will know, accessories is the main factor in dressing. If your accessories are attractive, you always be well-dressed. Now, a very important item in dressing is the scarf. A woman's scarf should always be will-o'-the-wisp. Just a touch of color to brighten the ensemble. Something very delicate like this. Something truly feminine. As they say in Portugal, a thing of beauty is a joy forever. And that brings us to woman's greatest problem and greatest joy, the hat. This season, they're wearing all manner of chapeau, just as long as it's made of straw. The bonnet is still very popular. Also, the more sophisticated, over one eye type. Which brings us to the question of dresses. According to the dictates of Paris, the latest thing in skirts is slits. A slit on this side and a slit on that side. But as you will notice, this skirt has 48 slits. One for each state. That brings us to the question of bags. Now, some of my best friends agree that the bag should not only be lovely, but also functional. Now, this bag is made of genuine beetle hide. Lined with asbestos, which is ever so clever in case you carry loose matches around in your bag. Of course, I always carry a makeup case in my bag. And incidentally, for a really good makeup, a lipstick brush is truly essential. One other little pointer, you should always have an aura of mysterious perfume around you. And if during the day it should sort of wear off, just carry an extra supply with you and give you a little touch here and there. For the last and final pointer, we come to that delicate little piece of feminine frippery which has come back into style so terrifically this past season. The difficult to get, but well worth the effort. There we are, the parasol. Now, if you will excuse me, I have an important date at the Caesar room of the Mills Hotel. I'll be seeing you again sometime.
Thank you, Imogene Coca. From down south in Corncob, Alabama, non-entities in the news, takes pleasure in presenting the world's first female tobacco auctioneer, Miss Susie Nicotine. Well, Miss Nicotine, for a woman, you really are in a unique profession. Why don't you tell us something about tobacco auctioneering? Miss Nicotine, do you handle much tobacco?
Well, I've been in the business now for 20 years. I guess in that time I bought about 50,000 tons of tobacco.
And that's a lot of tobacco. Did you manage to sell it all?
Sell it? Heck no, I smoked it myself. Get away from me, boys, you bother me.
I see. Are you a chain smoker, Miss Nicotine?
Never smoked a chain. I like a good cigarette, though. I like to roll my own. Would you like one?
Well, no, I don't think I'll join you. No,
well, now, I like to roll my own because I like to know what's inside one of them, you know. It's a very important thing. You don't happen to have a match, do you, sir?
I don't think so. You
well,
do
I
that.
I think I've got one. Wait a minute.
You do that with real skill, Miss Nicotine. I
must be broke. It never worked before.
Miss Nicotine, do you mean to say that you used up 50,000 tons of tobacco on cigarettes alone?
No, not in cigarettes alone. Now, I like a good cigar. Do you like cigars, sir?
Very good.
I like
bet.
A good cigar after my dinner. Mm-hmm. You don't mind if I smoke, do you?
No, certainly not. Go right ahead. You handle that with real skill, too. You know, Miss Nicotine, do you limit your smoking to just cigarettes and cigars? Because that doesn't seem to have any effect on you whatsoever.
No, I like a pipe now and then. Do you like a pipe?
Yes, a pipe's very relaxing, I think.
Would you like a little?
No, I just like to see what kind of a pipe you smoke. Boy, I don't imagine that a pipe tastes very good after smoking a cigar, though.
No, it doesn't.
No, I see. I think you must have a marvelous constitution to have smoked so many different things for such a long time without any ill effects. Miss Nicotine, are you all right? Can I get you something?
It's smoky in here tonight. Don't nobody inhale?
Thank you, Mary McCarthy. Now, from hot tamale, Mexico, non-entities in the nose brings you the world's greatest bullfighter. Señor Alfredo Caliente, Devora Valrey, saludos al vera mañana, Poloro Asante, enchilada, señor. Señor, is that your real name?
Si, señor, that's my real name. I also have a nickname.
And what is it?
Signor Alvarez, il dolore che ieri è staccato, ritenendolo io la dire, se vendo, correndolo, se vendono, però curandolo, se ne terlo, ritenendolo, cavandolo, se l'ora, stinchi.
Signor, how does it feel to be the greatest bullfighter in all the world?
Nice.
And, Signor, tell us, how do you feel when you meet the bull?
Scared.
Oh, you must be joking. Tell us, what's the first thing that happens when you step into the arena?
When I step into the arena, I step in, everybody, the men, they throw their hats. The women, they throw flowers, and they bow. Then the bull, he come into the arena. The bull come into the arena, he smell me. I smell the bull. The bull, he smell me. I smell the bull. So the bull smell much better than me. Then the bull, he charge at me. He charge to the right, I step to the left. He charge to the left, I step to the right. I notice the bull. He's got one weakness. If you kill him, he's dead. Then the bull come closer. I grab the bull by the horns. I got the bull by the horns. The bull, he got me by the hands. Now I look at the bull. The bull, he look at me. I look at the bull. The bull, he look at me. The bull is much better looking than me. Then I jump 30 feet in the air with the help of the bull. And when I come down, I bite the bull. The bull, he bite me. I bite the bull. The bull, he bite me. The bull may look better and smell better, but I taste better than the bull. Then the bull, he come closer, 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 closer. I pass him. I pass him this way. I pass him that way. He should never touch me.
Thank you, Sid Caesar. Tune in again next week for more non-editing in the news.
At this point, Marge and I would like to take you on a very small voyage to the South Pacific. There, on a little island overlooking the Pacific, you will find a very small South Pacific maiden. That's Marge. She's very happy on her little island until one day along comes a reformer. That's me. And so this is the story of the reformer and the maiden. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Sid Caesar.
On a trip around the world, one naturally stops off in London. And while in London, I happened to see a play. It was called Zero Hour. As I traveled on, I saw the same play in Paris. And it was very interesting to notice the difference between the English and the French styles of acting. To show you what I mean, I should like to do the play first as it was done in London, and then as the same play was done in Paris. The first scene takes place at the general headquarters of the Chief of Staff.
Gentlemen, attention. General Sir Archibald Woodbury. Hip hip, hurrah. Hip hip, hurrah. Hip hip, hurrah. Thank you very much, Audrey. Gentlemen at ease. Yes, the war. I'm sorry, isn't it? Yes, the plan of attack would be as follows. First, the infantry will move in. That's also pretty jolly well good, eh? And then comes the artillery. Boom! It's all ripping, eh? Got it off in there, yeah. And then finally, the crushing blow of the Royal Air Force. Zoom! Gentlemen, 0 hour will be precisely 0500. Let us synchronize our watches. 3, 2, righto. Gentlemen, I wish you all good luck. The next scene, the battlefield. It's about time. Right. Well, gentlemen, this is it. Or is it? Yes, it is, of course it is. Shall we? It's a long way to Tipperary. It's a long while to home. It's a long way. It's a long while to Tipperary. It's a It's a long while to Tipperary. Oh, there they are. Take that. And this too. It's a long voyage to Tipperary. It's a long voyage to carry on, chaps. Carry on. Carry on. Never mind about me. Carry on. Carry on. No, no gun get in. No water. Carry on. Carry on, boys. Carry on. Boom, 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 boom. Lieutenant to General Order, step forward. For bravery on the call to the license again, in order to make an order there. It was order to kill someone. First of all, I said an order to kill and restore your cross. Good luck, my boy. Toast. It's a long voyage. It's a long.
And now the same play as was done in Paris.
La facture est gilet bien Ferrara. Général Henri et passeur et Granard. Hourra! Hourra! Hourra!
Merci, mon capitaine. J'ai mes poissons et des jongles et mes bassins, mais tout sont pas mariarelles. J'ai mes belles bassons, un dégât, un bâtre, un bisou, j'arrive bien d'ailleurs. C'est les pédons.
Un but pas serré, j'ai ça, c'est vrai.
Sur mes pédons, j'ai arrêté son père, on double partout. J'ai marqué des gros bâtards, ou c'est mes poches, j'ai marqué un... Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy.
se met plus serré de son gérer. Elle attaque. Elle répond, elle a compté des fragiles. Infanterie. Il y a plus de temps. J'ai ainsi le temps. C'est plus de temps serré là. J'ai là. C'est plus de temps serré là. Attulé. Cible pas ton rêve, je l'ai tapé rare. Arrête-il à leur plaine. Cible pas ton rêve, je l'ai tapé rare.
Hein?
Dans ton perdu, je m'effacerai des arrêts. Le bonjour, oui, c'est pas toi. Hein? Cinq, cinq, cinq. Monsieur, elle est passée au déjà avec leur cœur. Je vais la serrer du gars. Bonjour. Zinexi, Zibet le fil. Je vais porter un redouin. Oui.
C'est bien pour se réduire sur ses rêves. Mais mes beaux joueurs, vas-y, c'est bien bien. Quel rôle déjà rêve. Donc on y est. Attention, Péronique, pas joué là, et tous. C'est mes beaux joueurs. Et par terrain, République. Douillou.
C'est mes beaux joueurs, mais tout ça rêve, le bonheur.
C'est mes beaux joueurs. You man.
Et nous, quand j'irai, ils disent ça en valeur, hein?
Have you, your sister. You got no sister? Got any friends? Vive la France!
Music playing and hearts alight. You'll hear a song that you'll remember. A song that's thrilling, filling the night.
The Monte Carlo is the tune that weaves its magic under the moon. The Monte Carlo is the theme that will be haunting you. Like a dream.
When lovers meet, they respond to its beat. They learn its charms in each other's arms. When there is a moon and romance is ahead, it isn't the tune, it's the words left unsaid.
Magic under the moon. The Monte Carlo is the theme that will be haunting you like a dream.
The Monte Carlo, the Monte Carlo, a song that's thrilling, filling the night.
Refrigerators, electric ranges, radios, record players, and magic mirror television